Residents have in the last 2 weeks been experiencing intermittent power outages, which they say sometimes last for 72 hours. The outages, according to them, are in more than 12 suburbs. They blame NETCO for the situation. Ascertaining what NETCO has been doing about the situation, the Energy Minister, John Peter Amewu, encouraged management of the power distributing company to be forthcoming with their challenges.
We have had some serious complaints, basically from our brothers and sisters, commercial workers, industrialists living around the northern region. The complaint has been very simple, that the persistent nature of the power interruptions can no longer be explained. For us, as people you put in positions to handle affairs of this country, such development is quite worrying. And so we deem it necessary to come to you today, not you, to come to Accra, to find out from you what the problems are.
The managing director of NETCO, Engineer Frank Akligo, who outlined their challenges, also assured steps are being taken to address them.
What we call the network parameters, transformers and others, were sized for maximum utilization by 1995, if you look at the study documents. What that meant was that by 1995, we should have a big reinvestment into the infrastructure to bring it up to standard. But unfortunately, that did not happen for a very long time. So we never had the type of investment we needed in the NETCO infrastructure until World Bank came to give us some $10 million and some few donor supports.
One of the issues that came to the fore at the meeting was illegal electricity connection. The Energy Minister outlined stiffer measures to arrest the practice.
It is clear that the level of penalty enshrined in this law is not deterring at all. So I can assure you that we'll start reviewing that regulation as quickly as possible. But again, we don't just want to review the regulation in isolation for the district managers that are also responsible in the area. And so as the punishment will be going for people who are responsible caught in the illegal, you know, or power theft, of course, if you are a district manager and you found that within your district jurisdiction there's this sort of power theft happening, we cannot leave you also alone. You also be held responsible.
While in the region, the minister also commissioned the first batch of a solar grid at Langatre in the West Gonja district. The symbolic commissioning sets the entire 26 powered facilities across the northern, Bonoahafo and western regions rolling. In all, the northern region has 11 of the projects, making it the highest beneficiary. It is followed by the Bonoahafo region and the western region, who have 9 and 6 of these facilities respectively. The project, which is aimed at improving primary healthcare delivery in the communities, is also to transform their livelihoods. Speaking at the commissioning of the project, the Energy Minister, John Peter Amewu, also announced an additional 38,000 standalone home systems and 55 mini-grids to be delivered under the Scaling Up Renewable Energy Program. Kojo Ajman, reporting for City Newsroom.